so many people, this is a night that they thought was never going to happen, whether they like Donald Trump or not. And for so many, he started out, he was simply a novelty candidate, more interested in building a brand than building a campaign. But each time he'd step into controversy, which was often self-imposed, he came out the other side stronger. And so was his support, who was stronger and more loyal. And tonight was the moment that they've been waiting for. And we were down on the floor with the New Hampshire delegation when that moment happened.
The following candidates received the following votes. 1,725 Trump.
While the outcome may have been known, the anticipation was there anyway. Then House Speaker Paul Ryan said the words that so many came to hear.
The chair announces that Donald J. Trump
has been selected as the Republican Party nominee for President of the United States.
For early Trump supporters who stood by him throughout, it was an emotional release.
You know, victory's a beautiful thing. It's great to see the team unite and come together as one.
Donald Trump won in New Hampshire for the first time, and that was the beginning of what we ended up here tonight. And the excitement that we had that night carried all the way through until tonight.
The moment was especially poignant for New Hampshire's lead delegate and the architect of the Trump campaign from its infancy, Corey Lewandowski.
After all you've been through this year, was it an emotional moment?
It was, because I was with my friends, the guys who believed early. It's great.
And while he's no longer with the campaign, Lewandowski is offering those who are some advice.
Look, I think what you got to do is realize that you're running against one of the greatest political machines our country's ever seen, the Clintons. And they will stop at nothing to win. And this election is too important, so no mistakes, no unforced errors, straight line, right to finish line in November, and take nothing for granted.
And for all the joy felt by Donald Trump supporters tonight, there was also a sense of relief. The fighting within the party is over because Donald Trump is now the leader of the Republican Party. The only thing that stands in his way now on the way to the White House is one formidable opponent in Hillary Clinton, who was, by the way, the focus of other speakers tonight that included Donald Trump Jr. and former Trump rival Chris Christie.
Time after time after time, the facts, and just the facts, lead you to the same verdict. Both around the world and here at home. In Libya and Nigeria, guilty. In China and Syria, in Iran and Russia and Cuba.
A president who will unleash the greatness in our nation and in all of us, who will give the hardworking men and women who built this great country a voice once again. That president can only be my mentor, my best friend, my father, Donald Trump.
So for so many supporters, tonight is a great night. Obviously, there's no more floor fights. The procedure part is over. No more roll calls. And tomorrow night, we are going to meet the man who is going to run this race with Donald Trump, Indiana governor and vice presidential nominee, Mike Pence. Certainly going to be a night that a lot of people are going to be watching, and we're going to be here live in Cleveland with live coverage for all of it. For now, reporting live in Cleveland, I'm Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.